my age pretty much can do what you want, right?
I gotta tell you something.
Okay.
Along that line, we just went on Easter Sunday to see my sister in law, Aunt Ruth, and this really fits this particular what you just said when you get to meet my age. So they were in their kind of their entertainment room, and I said, "There's Ruth right there." So the three of us, my older brother Marla and I, walk in there, and we'd just been there like 2 minutes, and standing in front of her, the TV was playing there, and this we're saying our hellos. This little old lady right over there, she said, "Would you get out of the way?" She said, "I can't see the TV." And I guess if, when you get to be that age, you can bump things.
And you know what? You and I are getting it.
We're a lot closer than where you're going.
Do I have a choice?
Probably not.
I just praise the Lord, I'm not your wife. I'm dedicating this song to Marvel. This song is to Marvel. It's called Amazing Grace. Make it white as snow. You know, we serve an awesome God. Amen? Amen. And this is an old time song. It's called Walk Around Me, Jesus. Amen. Sometimes that's all you can say, Jesus, I just need you. Just walk around. Just walk around. Amen. Just walk around. How many have ever said that? Jesus, I just need you right now. Amen.
Walk around me, Jesus. Walk around.
A part of God's amazing grace. Thank you. It is no secret what God can do. Oh.
Christian doesn't necessarily mean that you've truly committed your life to him. How many have been there and done that? Amen? Yeah. And that's what this song is. This is Therese Helmy's favorite song that I do it just for her all the time.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. And so Kyle and I are going to do it for you. It's called The God of the Mountain. You ready?
Life is easy. When you're up on the mountain and you got a peace of mind like you've never known, but then it's changed and you're down in a valley. Don't lose faith, 'cause you're the God on the mountain is still the God in the valley. When your faith will grow, he'll make it right. And the God of the cruel giants is still the God of the giants. And the God of the dirt God on the mountain.
when we go out and we minister like this, people, they just have a tendency to think, oh, it's hard for me, but everything in their life is okay. How many of you think that? Oh, come on, honestly. How many here think you're the only person here that ever has any problems? All right. This was written back in 2014. We were having a really interesting siege. And if you've ever been in a siege, you'll understand what I'm about to tell you. My daughter and her husband lost their house. The economy went, his job went, and they lost their house. They came and lived with us. Five boys, three dogs, and they came to live with my husband and I. On the weekends, we had Miss Jubilee, who was engaged to my other grandson, who's in college, and Kyle's friend, Brett. So we had 11 on the weekends. During that time, my husband was having severe trouble with his heart and could hardly do anything. We didn't know exactly what was going on, but it wasn't good. Then they found out that Isaac, the littlest one at that time, was blind in one eye, and the doctor didn't think that his eye would ever be restored. Joshua, the second to the youngest, the doctor said had a heart problem and heart blockage. This was all during this time, okay. And what else? There was some other stuff. Oh, his mother, no, your dad ended up with staph infection. He got hired at Harvest Food, ended up with a severe staph infection in his knee, almost lost his knee because of the staph infection. He was in the hospital and didn't know if the insurance company was going to pay the bill. Now, you just lost your house. You got no money, okay? You got a brand new job. Now you got staph in your knee, and they say you didn't get this at work. Okay, are you getting the picture? There is no income. There's no way to pay doctor bills. And my daughter has five bad discs. Five are bulging and three have ruptured. She is in bed. She has to drive to Missoula to have traction. Am I painting this? Okay. So I'm a full-time pastor. I really am. I mean, I work, I'm on the road all the time. And so when I come home, I'm doing the cooking and cleaning. And we're maintaining. This lasted for 14 months, Kyle? From, you moved in May and you moved out the next July. Yeah. So anyway, it was during that time. Oh, and then, of course, there was a lawsuit and just some other minor things in your life that are just falling apart. And, of course, if there's any people in ministry here, you know, the ministry is just so much fun. And, you know, and the thing is that God goes out and he saves the good people. You know, it's not people like us that were once alcoholics and drug addicts and all messed up. I mean, God goes out to the highways and the byways and he gets the really good ones. And so you have all of that as being a pastor on top of having 9 to 11 people at your house. And so at times it could be overwhelming. So the Lord gave me this song, and it's called "You're the God of the Day." And the reason I sing this song, it's one of our closing songs, is because there's a lot of you out there that are going through trials. Maybe you have cancer. Maybe you have heart disease like my husband. Maybe you have bad discs like my daughter, bedridden, five kids. Oh, yes. And then while they were living there, the sixth one come on the way. Yes, number six. Five bad discs, and you're pregnant with number six. Doesn't that sound like fun living with mama? But you know, we could, I could write a country song like, you know, the disc went in, the blind see, Josh is all right, praise be to me, everybody moved out. So anyway, through a series of events, well, it got so bad, I got really angry one night, and I says, We're going to start praying every night. We're going to kick the devil out of this house. I am sick of this. Do you hear me? I am sick of this. We're going to have a family prayer meeting every night. We're kicking the devil out of this. God ain't in any of this. We begin to pray. Isaac got, his eye went from 0 to 2880. Josh went in, had a heart test by a specialist. There was nothing wrong with his heart. Teresa ended up giving birth to a beautiful number 6 boy. Her back, she's working almost full time, isn't she, Jude? God touched her back. My husband, they don't know what's the matter with his heart. They tried to restart it and they can't. So you know, if they can't, God can. Amen?
Yes.
But then this miracle happened and somebody bought their old house. Now, and told them they could rent it. They're back in their old house, the one that the boys grew up in. Amen? This all happened, but it didn't happen until the last hour of the last day. The last hour of the last day. So we don't stand up here and say, you know, God is big, and don't believe it. God is big. We were praying that Billy wouldn't lose his hand, that Billy would be able to pray, but play. Amen.
2 more days, I'll lock my hand.
Yeah, 2 more days. He would walk. That's how serious it was. But you know, but God, I want you to say, but God.
But God.
You see, when you have a situation and God isn't in that, you can't even begin to believe for a good outcome. But you can have the worst situation, put God in it, and it's always going to be okay. Because God is bigger and greater than anything you can face. I was saved over the death of his son. And I tell people, I says, you want to talk about heartache? My altar was the tombstone of my son. And you can say, you don't know what I'm going through. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Been there, done that. And I can stand here and tell you, it doesn't matter what you're facing, God is more than enough for you. More than enough. The only thing that is standing between you and your miracle is you. God is up there. He says, whatever you ask in Jesus' name, it's yours. But have faith, not doubting. When you say to that mountain, be removed and cast into the sea. And you see, we look at the mountain, we say, God can't do anything. This is really bad. We have had some really, really bad situations. We have had financial situations. Ed and Pat have been part of our church for how many years now? 25. And we have been to hell and back at times. Because if you're living in a fallen world, you are going to have problems. You're going to have sickness. You're going to have disease. But you know, Isaiah 53 says it was our grief and our sorrow that he carried. It was our shame. And by his stripes we're healed. You know, he was bruised for our iniquity. And you say, you don't know what I'm going on in the inside. You know what a bruise is? He was bleeding on the inside. So it doesn't matter what's going on your inside. The blood of Jesus Christ is greater than any pain you're going to have because he already bore it. And God placed your sin upon his son. He became sin who knew no sin, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. I have no righteousness, but in Christ I become a royal priesthood. I become a son of the Most High God. I become a king.
Thank you, Lord.
That's what the Word of God says. That's what Jesus did for us. And many of us are saying, if God really loved me, I wouldn't be going through this. And I am here to tell you, you are going through this because he does love you.
Amen.
He knows what it's going to take to get you there. You see, he's already into eternity. Amen?
Amen.
And he's trying to get us ready for there. And so many of us are trying to get there by doing something. He did it. God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. And whosoever believeth, you know that word in Greek, believe, cling to, rely, and depend. Cling to, rely, and depend. And that word cling to means to adhere like a super glue. Now I'm going to ask you, when in your whole walk with the Lord, if you are with him, when has been your closest time where you can say, This is when Jesus touched me. Wasn't it in your low time? It wasn't on your mountain. It was on your low time. And it isn't that God wants us in our low time, but what God wants to do is to show us how big He is, how awesome He is, how mighty His love is. Audrey right now has a boy that is in a coma in Spokane. And she chose to come here and to share Jesus with you. Because God is more than able to take care of Bobby Dean. He was lost in drugs, ruined his whole life in drugs. But do you know what happened about 3 months ago, Brother Bill?
Yeah.
He gave his heart to Jesus and was baptized. Never too late. Never too late.
I started having a Bible study at my house every once a month. And that sowed the seed.
That sowed the seed. And now his other brother, who's been away, is really thinking about coming home to Jesus.
Amen.
Isn't that good?
Yeah.
So you just never know what your greatest miracle is going to be, so don't give up. Amen? So I hope you enjoy it. Are you two ready?
Okay.
You hold the God of the day. And you're the God of the night. You're the God of the storm. And the God who makes the sun to shine. I give my trust in you. Everything's gonna be alright. You're the God of the living. And you're the God of the night. You're the God of the storm. I know your word is true.
Thank you.
and I know it's getting late, but please eat some of them, would you please? And they have coffee. And if any of you need prayer while the rest of them are eating, we would be willing to pray with you. If you're facing something and you just feel like you're falling apart, just come forward and we would like to pray for you while everybody else is eating. All right, don't be shy. We are here to be a blessing to you. Amen.